McKay as Adam Troy. The Black Pearl. Guest stars, Patricia Medina, Anthony Steele, Kurt Kasnar, Lon Chaney. Brought to you by...
Buenos días, Sole.
Man, are you afraid of this?
Celeste, look what Tangy found.
Away!
Yippee!
I'd give my life to own a pearl like this.
That's about what it cost.
Makes with coconut milk. Isn't there any place around here to get a decent drink?
Sure, if you got the time. There's an Englishman with a cellar full of Scotch whiskey near here.
How far is it?
Over on the other island. It's only about 2 hours by canoe.
At what time do we sail for Mappa Island?
Tomorrow night.
I ask at what hour, if you please.
1800 hours. If the tide's on time, that is.
Why do we have to wait there another full day? Simply so your colleague, Captain Troy, can amuse himself with that nonsense of pearl diving.
No, that's not it. We're held up on account of one-arms cargo.
This delay is intolerable to me. By the time we get to Mappa, the pearl market may be sold out.
I wish there was something I can do here, Wagner.
All stowed, Mr. Key. There'll be plenty of room aft for the copra when it gets here.
Thanks, Thompson. You can knock off now, too. They're back 3 hours ahead of time. They really must have found something. There'll be excitement tonight.
Excitement?
Here?
Now we have those infernal drums beating all night long.
I'm going ashore. Anybody want to come?
No, thanks.
Okay, see you later.
It would appear that our captain has found something more than pearls to keep him, amused. Wait. Most women are like shadows. Follow them, they fly. Fly from them, they follow.
Good man. What goes on?
Watch and see.
Most likely.
Hey, is one on back yet?
No, he's still on the copper side.
I want to thank you for a glorious day.
It can be a glorious night, too, after the Pia Pia.
Oh, yes.
There's a waterfall I know near the lagoon. It should be a mass of rainbows when the moon gets to it.
That sounds enchanting. Knock on my door in 5 minutes.
4 minutes.
I have no idea how much we missed you. Oh, darling.
Did you have a pleasant afternoon, Captain?
Some days are just better than others, Mr. Remley.
I'm sure they are.
You look, my dear. Is it the sun and fresh air that's responsible, or the skin diving lesson from Captain Troy?
You should have come along. It was enchanting.
I'm sure it was enchanting, but I didn't feel you wanted me along.
But I asked you to come.
But you didn't really mean it, did you?
Darling, please.
How swiftly and generously you scatter your favors, my dear.
Oh, don't be a fool, child.
I don't intend to be. I'll try to be just as attractive and gallant as I was when you and I and your late husband first met in Tahiti.
Darling, don't you see? I'm trying to put on my lipstick.
And I'm only trying to tell you the plans I've made for us tonight.
Tonight?
Yes. He tells me that a couple of hours by canoe from here is an island owned by a countryman of mine. And best of all, he has a cellar full of scotch.
Trust you to smell that one out.
I'll have a canoe and a native paddler wait for us on the beach. A moonlight sail, and we'll be back by noon tomorrow.
I'm so sorry, my darling, but I've made other arrangements.
I imagine Captain Troy is involved. Do you remember your hotel suite in Tahiti just 3 weeks ago? Your husband lying dead on the floor. The French police chief asking all those embarrassing questions. How charming and understanding he was when I swore you were with me all evening. But of course, if I hadn't sworn you were with me, you'd be in a Tahiti jail cell right now. Wouldn't you? With a murder charge lodged against you.
But you did swear. You took an oath, didn't you? Darling, why are we quarreling? All Captain Troy wants to do is to show me a native celebration. Why don't you go? Take advantage of the Englishman's hospitality.
Hmm? Yes, perhaps I will. But you know, it's one thing to catch drinks from a man, another to beg bottles, my dear.
sorry. Forgive me, of course. Well, don't you see if he can sell you a case? After all, we have a long, long time together on this boat. Here.
Thanks.
Oh, my child. If there's a store on that island, why don't you buy me a nice present, too?
How nice it must feel. Always dispensing this lovely money.
Evening, Mr. Rempel.
A pleasant evening, Captain Troy.
Let's go. Remley isn't too much interested in our little Fia Fia.
Mr. Remley is out finding civilization and whiskey. Oh, and I forgot. He asked me to tell you that he found out through your Mr. Key that he has a friend on a neighboring island, and he's going to visit it. And he is not going to return to the ship. Message delivered.
We'll try hard not to miss Mr. Remley too much. Hopefully. Watch this.
What are them devils doing back here before dark? Answer me that. What are they doing?
Oh, now you find it here, Tia. Tangi.
Tangi?
Ha ha.
There's no reason to go. Tangi! Where did you find Tangi?
Say it, Tamato boy.
Must be worth a fortune. Here on the island, for instance, it's worth a boar's tooth necklace.
Some people worship money. Others worship things.
Like a boar's tooth?
Or even a pearl.
Even a pearl.
Tell me something. In terms of money, how much is it worth?
Depends. Wagner might pay $5,000 for it. Less if you get away with it. But if you bought it in New York, you'd have to pay $50,000 for it.
A wise woman would not wait until she gets to New York to buy it.
You know what you are, Tangi. You're a hero. You know what I'm going to do because you're a hero? I'm going to give you my store. Yeah, you and all your no-good, wonderful people, I'm going to give you my trading post.
What a guy, isn't he?
Hey,
Head of one arm. I make you an offer. $4,000 for the pearl.
Why, you no good pearl dealer. You never made a square deal in your life. And now this. You offer me $4,000 for the greatest pearl ever dug out of the ocean. $4,000. That's what you offer me is $4,000.
It's a good price, I assure you, trader.
If you offer $4,000, I can get 40. And I'll get it. Yeah. Yeah, I'll get it. I'll get it in Australia. I'll go to Australia and get it myself. Come, Troy. Come, Troy.
Here I am, one arm.
Come, Troy. You're sailing tomorrow with Trader One Arm. Understood?
We'll talk about it in the morning.
Drunk or sober, I am sailing with you. Understood?
Understood.
But I'm going to take my oldest and best friend with me.
Huh?
Oh, you're looking at the waterfall. You want to look at the sky. Come on.
All right.
Now concentrate.
Yes. Well,
follow my finger.
Mm-hmm.
One. Two. Three.
Four. Yes, I see them. One, two, three, four.
Southern Cross.
The Southern Cross.
Find those four stars and you'll never lose your way in the South Pacific.
Your sky is beautiful. And so is the waterfall.
And so are you.
It's moments like this that I do not understand.
Understand what?
Myself. Here I am on this beautiful island, a paradise. And yet I've never been more frightened in my life.
Frightened? Of what?
It all began in Tahiti with my husband's death. I do not believe that I will breathe freely again until I am back in Fiji, on the plane to Paris.
Opposites. The opposites attract. I couldn't wait to get back to the islands when I got out of the Navy. You can't wait to run away from them.
You've been happy here. I haven't. Tell me, don't you ever want to return to America?
Someday, when I can buy my own ranch. Not right now.
Oh, but you do at rest. Adam, why can't the Tiki sail at dawn tomorrow instead of waiting for the evening tide?
To get one arm's cargo loaded.
But wasn't it supposed to be loaded this morning while we were swimming? It's not your fault if it's not ready.
Well, I have a commitment to one arm.
And what about my plane? You also have a commitment to me. If we run into a storm or any kind of bad weather, I won't make the plane. Adam, could you?
Said I would.
Could you sail in the morning instead of waiting for the evening? I know you want to wait for one arm's cargo. But tell me, do you really think the natives would work tomorrow? You yourself said this Via Via would go on for days and days. Adam, please.
Well, all right.
Thanks.
I'll get the other cargo loaded and tell Oliver to round up the passengers.
How lucky that Mr. Remley decided to stay on that other island. He would never be here in time for the boat to sail.
And now, we will not talk about Mr. Remley.
I've got a full cup.
Oh. Bet you're glad to be sailing ahead of schedule.
Be more pleased if one arm and his black pearl had come with us.
You didn't really think you'd leave Racker hanging, did you? been married to that island for 20 years.
Pleasant time of day for a sailing. We must thank our captain for sending Mr. Key to inform me of the new hour of departure. Mustn't we, Celeste?
Our good skipper should always be responsible for the welfare of every one of his passengers.
No kidding.
My solemn word. I didn't think it possible. This chicken's even tougher than the one you served us last week.
Oh. How much can you do with an island chicken?
A great deal, I suspect. Right, Captain?
Civilized food is disgusting, all of it.
And why go back to civilization?
This is everything I came to the islands for.
I would like to, at your convenience, reopen negotiations, trader.
I told you there was nothing more to deal with me about.
Trader, may I just for a moment look?
Here, hold your hand. What you are, disgusting. Drooling your greed. You'd do anything for this pearl, wouldn't you? You'd rob or you'd kill. Well, go ahead and drool, my friends. This is my pearl. I'm top dog now. And I aim to keep it that way. Now, I'm going topside, where the air's clean.
Last 2 days in Australia, if he's lucky.
If he ever gets there, that is.
Great night. Yeah, they all seem the same to me. You really don't like the Pacific, do you, Thompson?
Nope.
Whatever brought you out here?
I guess you've never been divorced, have you, Captain?
You ever going back?
To what? And with what? I've got nothing. Any place with nothing is just the same as any other place.
Maybe.
Sailor pulling by.
Aye, aye, sir.
Adventures in Paradise.
What is it? What did he say?
He says many years ago, shark ought to take his arm. Now, one arm all with shark god.
Well, an odd accident.
This is no accident. We all know one arm was carrying a fortune around his neck.
You're not suggesting that any of us?
Thompson, you were at the wheel. What did you see?
Well, not much. As far as I knew, one arm was near the rail, forward of the deck cargo, right up there.
Okay, then what happened?
Well, then I heard this crazy scream. I turned around and saw one arm lurching into the water. I started yelling man overboard, and that's when you came up.
Wagner, where were you?
I? Where should I have been? In my cabin, asleep.
I can vouch for that, as I was asleep in the same dreary cabin. Reluctantly, I must confess.
Can you vouch for him, Wagner?
Regrettable, this I cannot do. I was asleep already when Mr. Emily came back from,
From where?
From, But he was.
Well, where were you, Remley?
Gallantry forbids me to say.
Oh, don't be a fool, Charles. Mr. Remley was with me.
Thank you for returning the favor, my dear.
Let's go, Oliver.
Oh, Captain, just what do you propose to do?
I propose to contact Tahiti to give a full report on passengers and events and await instructions from the local police.
The police?
That's right, the police.
the interference is fierce.
Last night's report said there were squalls heading for Tahiti.
That's all we need.
What if you can't get through?
It sounds like a firefight.
Like Pusa. Remember? You and I didn't even know each other back in those days. You skipping a landing barge, me in a foxhole.
Yeah, Pusa. One long, lousy foul-up.
We both got through okay. Who do you think did it, Adam?
You saw those faces at dinner? So did one of. Any one of them would have committed murder that minute. I'd give anything to know where that pearl is.
Could be in some shark's belly.
I'll lay you 100 to 1 it's in the murderer's pocket.
You're on, but how are you going to prove it?
No dice on a direct signal to Tahiti. I'm trying the Honolulu relay.
Honolulu? You're out of your mind.
I paid $750 for this transmitter, despite your complaints, just for an emergency like this.
Calling KHA, Honolulu.
Calling.
Calling KHA, Honolulu.
Honolulu? Honolulu? This is KQR, Schooner Tiki.
I must contact KBK, Tahiti.
Will you assist? Clear with Honolulu. Out.
That chanting can get to be quite a bore, can't it?
To me, it is maddening. He may continue this for 3 days and nights and never stop.
Well, that should be fine.
I will not tolerate this ridiculous noise.
Samari's chanting doesn't seem to disturb you, my dear.
It's not the only noise that is intolerable.
Perhaps. But if anyone aboard could be considered passionate enough to commit murder, it's mine here, Wagner. With the exception, of course, of you, my sweet. Cigarette?
Thank you, Honolulu. Keep trying, will you? Out. They can't get through either.
Real cozy. Now what do we do?
Captain Troy. Captain Troy! I demand to know what goes on around here.
Herr Wagner, it's considered common courtesy to knock at a door and wait for someone to say, come in. And on my ship, it's obligatory.
All right. May I come in now, Captain Troy?
For what?
I believe you're aware there's an extreme urgency for me to proceed to Mapa Island.
I'm aware. But you may have to change your plans. I'm waiting for instructions.
What sort of instructions? You must tell me!
I don't have to tell you anything. Police instructions. We may return to Tahiti.
Tahiti? I demand that you disembark me on Mapa Island.
Sorry.
I insist! My entire livelihood depends on the pearl harvest in Mapa. Without it, my business is ruined.
That's very unfortunate. I can't do anything about disembarking anybody till I hear from the police in Tahiti.
Oh, I'm a good friend to the Tahitian police. Let me speak to them, if you please.
Nobody touches that radio but Captain Troy and I.
Do not interfere with me, you cut it, Wagner.
One more word out of you and I'll lock you in your cabin. Now get out and stay up. I guess I'll go on deck. Tell the men to stand by, Thompson. We may be reversing course.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Captain Troy, are you really going to reverse course?
I won't know until I contact the police in Tahiti.
But will they make you turn back?
Perhaps.
Adam, you can't possibly think that I could murder one arm. I couldn't have done it. I couldn't have the strength. I am just a woman. Please, Adam, please don't take me back to Tahiti. I beg of you, don't do that. You do not realize how desperate it is for me.
I'm sorry. We may have to return to Tahiti.
evening, dear Celeste, but earlier in the evening I failed miserably without approach.
Get out of my cabin.
Not without the Black Pearl.
I haven't got it.
Innocence doesn't become you, darling.
Oh, Charles.
Where is it, Celeste?
I do not know.
We're bound for Tahiti. The police might question me again. That's what you're afraid of, isn't it? What I might say if they question me again? So you see, Celeste, your freedom really depends upon me. The pearl, please.
I haven't got it. Why do you keep insisting that I do have?
Because I came back to your cabin about the same time the Trader One Arm went overboard. And your cabin was empty. Because I know you when you want something. You killed him just as easily as you killed your husband.
I didn't kill my husband. I told you that in Tahiti. You didn't really believe me, did you?
Not really. And where were you that night?
On the beach.
Oh. Alone?
No, of course not alone.
Then why did you ask him to perjure himself for you?
Because I needed a friend. Someone I could depend on. That's why I asked you. And you didn't even believe I was innocent.
The police believed you, and that remains the primary concern. Give me the pearl and I'll intrude no more. No more requests for money. No more proposals. But I want that pearl.
I haven't got it. How many times do I have to tell you? I haven't got it. I haven't got it. I haven't got it.
Pardon me. I don't want to interrupt a friendly discussion. Just checking to see that it remains friendly.
Thank you for your concern, Captain. But Madame Solange and myself have been, and still are, on the best of terms. That is so, isn't it, my dear?
Yes.
Okay, that's the way you want it.
Captain Troy, please, may I have a word with you for a moment alone? Do you mind?
No, not at all. We can continue our discussion at breakfast. Or perhaps sooner. Pleasant dreams.
You really are the only friend I have left now.
What do you want, Celeste?
I need your help. Charles came in here a moment ago. He smashed the door, and he had terrible threats and accusations. I have to get away from him.
What do you want, Celeste?
I want you to put me ashore on the nearest island, anywhere. But get me away from this ship and from Charles, please.
I haven't contacted the Tahitian police yet. Until I do, everyone concerned stays aboard.
I'm so frightened.
I'm sorry. There's nothing I can do.
And then the last night, you said you wanted one day to have a ranch. Supposing I were to help you to
no
get
no deal, Celeste.
Please, I'll...
Save the tears.
No.
I'll send Thompson to fix the lock.
Checked it just before we sailed.
It's broken now.
That's funny.
Fix it.
Yes, sir.
Hold it a second, Thompson. Trouble, Adam.
Let's have it.
Maybe you better come see for yourself.
Thompson, take the wheel.
All right, Captain.
Wagner.
It's a heavy sea, Wagner. I think you're better off below.
Couldn't be worse above than it's down below. Perhaps even better. I'm a paying passenger, but I have to go where I please. I'm looking for that up, too.
Stand by and come about.
I locked it. Precaution. Look what someone did to your 750-buck transmitter.
Absolutely useless. That settles it.
Back to Tahiti?
Yeah. The murder on board. Does anybody else know about this?
Can't say. I saw your door was open, and I thought it was peculiar, so I started to close it, and...
Yeah.
I'm beginning to feel this could be even worse than Pusa.
No, stop this.
You can answer a couple of questions for me. What else did you throw overboard? Or should I say, who else?
No. No, Captain, I didn't. I swear I didn't. No.
Mr. Key will take you to your quarters.
Stop that.
Consider yourself under arrest until we land. You're forcing you have to.
Hear about this.
Been one lousy voyage for you to Maui. I'm sorry.
Ada, I say to you, more bad to come.
I hope you're wrong, Tamaui. Sure, what goes?
Must speak secret.
Okay.
Adam, you know who killed One Arm?
No, Tamaui, not yet.
You know?
No.
Tamaui know only who so kill he no get black pearl.
He did?
No.
How do you know that?
One Arm give me. He much feared bad people come steal pearl.
Let me get this straight. One Arm gave you the pearl to keep for him?
Ah, I had.
Where is it?
I give you.
One?
I much fear bad people come look. Better you keep pearl, huh? They kill me, no find pearl.
Nobody's gonna harm you, Tamaui.
Maybe. But if that thing does happen, then maybe you find out who kill One Arm, huh? Please.
Okay, haha. But don't forget to ask me for it in Tahiti.
Yes, Adam.
The wheel and start forward.
So you dump me over like you did One Arm, huh?
That's right, Captain. You're going over the side and I'm going back to the States.
How come you think you got it made?
Because now I can go back with something real big. I'll take the pearl if you don't mind, Captain.
How come you figure I got it?
I don't figure, I know. One Arm didn't have it, he must have given it to Tamaui. Tamaui didn't have it, must have given it to you. And you're the last one that saw him before he died.
Died
very suddenly. Now, come on, give me that pearl. All right, Captain, give me the pearl.
I wish I'd never seen it.
It's gone back to the depths of the sea where it belongs. Maybe the salt water can wash it clean again.
If you'll take over, Captain, I'll lock up Thompson.
Okay, partner. We're on our way.
Right.